Welcome to ELO's tutorial on how to close caption your lectures by using a document created in Dragon NaturallySpeaking and syncing it to your video in YouTube. Step 1 briefly covers how to set up an account using Dragon. If you've used Dragon before and you already have a user account associated with Dragon, you do not have to follow this step. If you are using Dragon NaturallySpeaking Pro for the first time, you'll be prompted to set up an account with a username. Through this process, you will be required to read a text, which will take about 30 minutes. For the sake of this training video, I am going to skip that whole step and just show you the first couple clicks before you start reading. The reason why you have to read the text is so Dragon has a chance to first learn and adapt to your voice. Essentially, the more you use Dragon, the more it will adapt to your voice and your speech style. The second step is to convert your video into an audio file. It is assumed that you already have a lecture video that you want to transcribe. For this video, we will use VLC. VLC is a media player that allows you to convert file formats from one style to another. For example, if you take an MP4 video lecture, you can pull out the audio separately into an MP3 file. So here I am taking the MP4 and converting it into an MP3. I go to Media, click on Convert and Save, then I have to choose what file type I want to convert it into. Here I'm just going to convert it into an MP3. When that is finished, I'm going to choose a destination folder and hit Start. This process can vary in length, but it's generally pretty fast. It really depends on how long your video is. Step 3 is the process of taking your audio file and transcribing it using Dragon. So now that we have our MP3, it's time to go back to Dragon. You need to click on Tools, then Transcribe Recording. From there, you locate your MP3 and tell Dragon to transcribe. This process will also vary in length depending on how long your audio file is. In this example, Dragon has added punctuation because I had the option turned on. It's still a good idea to go back through your transcript and make sure the punctuation is correct. Once Dragon is finished with the transcript, you can either edit in DragonPad or copy it and paste it into Word. Either way you do it, you will still have to go back through and double check the transcript. As you do this more often, the less mistakes Dragon will make. What we would recommend doing is having the transcript open in Word while you listen to the audio file in VLC. That way you can listen to your voice and make the corrections. Please remember, when you're editing your transcript created in Dragon, your text should match your audio verbatim. When your text matches your audio perfectly, students relying on closed captions will have less confusion. The next step is the process of retraining Dragon with the file you just edited. Once you are done editing your transcription, you will need to go back to Dragon and have Dragon learn from your edited document. To do this, you go to Vocabulary, Learn from Specific Documents. You'll be taken to a new screen where you need to check both Find Unknown Words and Find Known Words with Unknown Capitalization. When you do this, it helps Dragon learn to your speech pattern and improve over time. The next step is to upload your video into YouTube and take your file from Dragon and sync it to the video so you can have closed captions. What we recommend is using YouTube to combine the transcript and the video. You don't have to keep your video in YouTube. When you're done, you can download it as MP4 and remove the file if you like. We suggest YouTube for this process because YouTube auto-syncs your transcript to the video, saving you time and effort. The first thing in the step is to log into YouTube. If you do not have a YouTube account, you will need to create one. You can choose at this point to leave the video public, private, or unlisted. If it is unlisted, you can still use it in your course, but people on YouTube will be unable to find it. Uploading times can vary, but essentially you will have to wait a few minutes. When uploading is finished, click on Done, return to Video Manager, click on your video title, then go to your settings, and then go to the Subtitles and Closed Captioning area on the top of the screen. And this is where you will add the transcript that you edited and used in Dragon. Once you have clicked on Upload a File and picked your transcript, you have to give YouTube a moment to auto-sync. This process can take a little while. It is easier to click back every once in a while or refresh your page to see if it has finished auto-syncing. When it is done auto-syncing, go back to your captions, make sure they are correct. You can make adjustments on the fly if you need to. Then click Publish in the upper right-hand corner. As I mentioned before, you could also download your video as MP4 with your captions. If you would like to do so, go back to your Video Manager, click on the little arrow next to Edit, then select Download MP4. In this video, we covered how to pull an audio file from your lecture, how to convert the audio file into a written text using Dragon, how to update Dragon so it can learn to your speech style and improve over time, how to upload your lecture into YouTube and automatically sync it to your new transcription created in Dragon. Thank you for watching our tutorial.